Hello friends, welcome to the EduSat Network. Today we are going to discuss how to implement development communication programs. Say what are the issues and how these issues can be solved. And this discussion will be taken up by our subject expert, Dr. Devesh Kishore, renowned academician in the field of journalism and mass communication. He has a vast academic experience of over 40 years and the title of his recently published book is Development Communication, published in 2012 by Harihar Publication. So of course you could make use of this wonderful book and resourceful book that he has made available for all the students. So with that, let us welcome sir and request him to begin our today's lecture. Thank you for being here, sir.
Thank you very much for introducing. Today we are going to have interactive session on how to implement development communication programs. Planning, designing development communication program is of course an important step. But suppose even if you have worked out a very good outline of a development communication program, but the most important thing is how it is implemented. Whole thing depends upon implementation. If the implementation is not proper, you may have designed keeping several points in mind, but the person who is executing it, he has not taken care of those points during implementation stage, then the program is likely to be less effective or it may fail. It has been seen that there are international agencies who design a very good development communication program for a country or for a particular purpose. But when it comes to implementation stage, those who execute, those who are involved in the project, if they do not take care of basic fundamental points of implementation, then this project most of the time fails, and then people think it has failed because the project was not good. I think the most important thing is the implementation. Even a weak project, if implementation is good, it will survive and people will appreciate it. So today our basic discussion would be how to do that. First thing is, I would like to take you to a approach which I call it a funnel approach, zooming in on key issues. I think always is very important the key issues which are inbuilt into the programs have to be taken care of. First thing is, first type of problem you always face when you are going to implement the program is how to build trust, because you are an outsider, you are not one of the member of their society, you are expert in your own area, but the problem arises these people for whom the program has been worked out, now those how and why they should believe on you, and that if they don't believe on you, if they don't trust you, then the project will not be implemented properly. So how to build the trust? The most important thing in building the trust is you must listen to them. You should not go on talking from your side only. Listen what they want to say. Go deeper into the thoughts which they have in their mind. Answer those questions which they have about the project. Develop proper understanding. Once you have developed a proper understanding about your project, its objectives, its aims, then the other end, that is the receiver end, would be very happy to get involved in that. That means you will have to develop perception about your program. They should be able to perceive in advance how it is going to be useful to them, what benefits will accrue from this program. And next thing which is very important, interest itself, take care of their cultural value system, social value system. Because if you don't take care of the cultural and social value system, then you will be out of that society. Take care of that, in what values they will eat the more, what values they work according to the value system, because country to country, society to society, community to community, the cultural values have differences. Don't try to push your value system on them, otherwise they will not accept it. So first thing is what? Building trust. Why I say funnel approach? That first thing is, which has to be done, is the trust to be established, rapport to be established, understanding to be developed, perception to be made very clear. All that has to be done as a on the top of it. Then you go to the second layer of it, that is the exploring issues, which is very important. Exploring issues means they may have problems, they may have certain priorities for the problems, they may have certain needs, or they may have opportunities. Now you have to explore it. What are their basic issues? What are their fundamental issues? What are their general issues? What are their issues which they think is the most important for them? Until unless you are not able to explore, if you are able to explore, good. If you have not explored, then if suppose you implement your project, they will not be able to link it up with their system. And they will say, no, this is a program thrusted on us from the top. Even if they participate, they will be participating without any zeal, interest, because they don't know what the benefits they will get. So the exploring the issues, you have to do it. You may have to talk to them, you may have to discuss with them, you may go to groups to groups, you go to different members of the society and go on exploring. After you have explored, then your responsibility is how to convert them into specific issues. Because it's very difficult to handle all the issues what they have mentioned. Now, as per your project, objectives, aims, whatever you have worked out, you identify those issues. And then you say, these are the specific issues which I will take care of. You will decide yourself. And then find out the causes and effect. If I handle this issue, what is going to be the effect on the society or on the people? And what will be my best option? So that I can tell them, look, this is the way how some of these your problems which you have mentioned to me can be solved by this project. And then you work it out, what define what changes are required. So this I call it funnel approach, because there are four layers in it. And if you go by layer, then you will be able to reach to a point where you will be able to define what change is required in the society. And this change you are not deciding yourself, you are deciding on the basis of what participants have to say in relation to their problems, what participants want to prioritize, what they want to handle, and what are the objectives of your project. And then you reach to the what change is required. That's why this is a funnel approach. And then we come to the next step, that is, how do we identify and define issues.
Sir, at this point, if I could interrupt you and ask you a question, is that we have talked about the funnel approach, and you have also explained that funnel has four layers, and if I am not wrong, and that is why it is called the funnel, it takes the shape of a funnel. But why have you specifically chosen to take this approach? Are there any other approaches, or is this the best available approach?
Very good question you have asked. You see, why do we use funnel? If we have to pour a liquid from a big size utensil to a bottle, then you keep a funnel. Why do you use funnel? You can pour it like this. You use funnel because nothing will go out of the mouth of the bottle or spill over. It will be directed by the funnel to the bottle. So the danger of spilling, danger of wasting the liquid is avoided by funnel. So what happens here? You as a development communicator, you when you explore the issues, you find there are hundreds of issues. Like a utensil having lot of liquid. So you have lot of issues. Now this lot of issues you want to convert into the project so that it can be worked out as it can be launched. Therefore, you will have to select in some manner so that the important things goes into the funnel, rest remains outside. So the important thing is, through this approach, what are you doing? You are first establishing the trust. After trust, you are exploring the issues. After exploring the issues, then you are going to third step, and like fourth step, you are also, that is needed change. So there can be another approach also. You do may not use funnel approach. You may take the whole utensil and you may pour the liquid into the bottle without funnel. But I am sure it is a very difficult task. Something will spill over, or you have to have a lot of control on your hands so that there should be a the liquid should fall in the bottle itself. So if lot of problems are there, if you don't apply use this approach, then you get entangled into several problems which you may not be able to handle, which you may not be able to use, which may, they may not be your objectives, and then the participants will always tell, these are the my problems and you have not been able to handle it. So that is why you should have a directional approach. You must try to direct. As a communicator, you are a leader there, and the leader helps the followers in going in right direction, going doing the things in a proper manner. Therefore, I suggested the funnel approach.
Right. Thank you, sir. And as we learned, it's a directional approach. And we'd request sir to resume the lecture.
Let's go to the steps. And most important thing is how to identify and define issues. I always say, if you have been able to identify right type of issue, and you will you have been able to explain the same, then you have done almost half of the work related to the development communication program. So what are the methods? One method is exploratory, that you go to the target audience, you go to the geographical area, you yourself observe in terms of your objectives, what is happening there in the society, what are their issues, what are their problems. So exploration. You nothing have in your mind which will bias you. You go on exploring and then you collect lot of information from the audience are from the area. That's number one technique which you can use. Another technique is topical, that you go and talk to them and find out what are the problems which are the topical problems. Third is felt need based. Now this is a new technique. Felt need based. Need based, we understand that whatever there are needs, the program can be built on that. But why felt? Felt means there are needs, but they are not feeling it. They are only in upper surface. For example, in a particular area where you are taking up the project, you find number of cases of cholera, diarrhea are found and reported. So the participants will say, so something is wrong somewhere here. Every year we have cases of smallpox, diarrhea, and several types of stomach upset. So we should have a doctor, good doctor, to identify and give the medicines. We have a stock of medicines. Now this is their need. But try to understand why cholera takes place, why diarrhea takes place, why stomach upset takes place, because there all around filthy objects are there. House flies are there, and these house flies carry the bacteria and all that to their food items. So you can suggest, well, you made a good point, but if you can save your food items from these flies, keep them covered, or in houses have those doors by which house flies cannot enter into your house, or you can take care of them, then you will have no cases of diarrhea or cholera. Now that is a felt need. It means their roads should be clean, drainage water should be out, there should not be collected outside the house, there should be proper disposal of waste material from the house, it should not be thrown outside your house on the street, there should be a proper system. Now that is a felt need. So felt need, since you are an expert, you will be able to identify. If this can be done, then this is happening. Therefore, if we can teach them or we can tell them importance of not only cleaning the house, but also keeping the all streets also very clean, proper drainage system, and all that has care has to be taken. So that is a felt need based. Next is
Before we move on to the next step, participatory, could we elaborate a bit more on felt need based, and also are there any techniques for identifying these needs?
Yes, actually felt need based is a concept which is very important for a development communicator. Few years back we were always saying that your development communication program should be need based, and that was all right, that whatever needs is mentioned by them, we take it, and on that need we try to build up the whole thing. As I just explained in the earlier case, they said that they require a hospital and a doctor, and there should be some methodology to control cholera epidemic, diarrhea, etc., etc. Now, once this need has been indicated, now your job is to find out why this need has arisen. Is the water supply in that area is good enough? How do they drink the water? Do they drink the water from the pond, collect it, or they take the water from a river, especially during rainy season, water becomes contaminated. You can tell them, use some filters, and with the help of filters, or if somebody is sick in your house, then give him only boiled water, so that it will kill all the germs and the bacteria. Or you have some other system, like RO system and all that. Now these type of things, recommendations about the project, that becomes the felt need. So therefore, felt need has been said. For example, now this cleanliness, I was listening to the budget yesterday, and it was said that they are now emphasizing on better toilets. Now you see, at a national level, when you have come to a problem on toilets, everybody is thinking, what is this problem? This is nothing. Why should we invest? But if you see the implications of it, if every house will have a toilet, then what will happen? Especially it will be convenient for the family members. They need not to go to the outside. They save themselves from the danger of safety. They will be more safe in their house. You can use it at any time. Many cases we find are happening because they have to go outside the house during odd hours. That creates problem. Next, cleanliness. So there are several things which are attached with the toilet, and therefore they are the felt needs, and that is the first thing which should be made available to the people: clean water, toilet facilities. I think it should be made as a basic amenities which any government should be able to look into it. And then when this felt need is taken care of, there are a lot of problems they will be saved up. That is what we say felt need based. I think the people will have to understand the whole concept, especially development communicator should know how to work out felt needs and indicate to them that this is very important for you, and this can save you from so many implications which are being arise. That's what we say felt need based. Second, next we have said participatory. I think participatory, everybody is clear that we must go on discussing with them, trying to find out from them what they want to say about their needs and issues and problems what they have. That has to be worked out. Next is futuristic approach. Now you, as a development communication expert, you should be able to indicate what are their future needs, which they may not understand today. But you can work out this is going to be your future requirement. For example, if you find in the area that many youths do not have jobs, they are unemployed, or youths are coming up and there are no industries in that area, or there is no business or type of programs where youth could be employed. Now that may be after 5 years, 10 years, the problem may arise. But as development communicator, you should be able to identify it and say, well, you must try to develop some industry in your area, or try to develop certain activities in your area, so that your youth could be gainfully employed. If you have not worked out And if you have not thought out, because if any activity you want to do, it takes 2 or 3 years to build up that thing. Now, for example, near Ludhiana, near in Punjab, very interesting thing happened. The horticulture department emphasized that why don't you grow grapes instead of wheat, and then you will get a lot of money, because grape sells at about at least 100 rupees or 50 rupees a kilo. So most of the farmer understood. They said, yeah, this is a good idea. And he said, I will tell you how to grow the grapes. And he explained them everything, and the people started growing. Now, when the farmers have grown the grapes, a lot of grapes have come. When they went to the market, then what happens? Grapes prices fall down. Why they have fallen down? Because the people who eat grapes, grape cannot replace the food items, dal, roti. Grape is only fruit. It will not happen that person will not eat any lunch or dinner and will go on eating grapes. So what happened? The prices went down. And it went down to some extent, to such an extent, that prices of grapes were much lower than the onion. Now, onion is used in all the vegetables. And what happened? After 3-4 days, grape started rotting, because you cannot store it. And we started rotting, the people said, please take it free. No charges, because if grape is not removed, then there will be a foul smell all around. Now you see what went wrong in this project. It was a good project, no doubt. But what has not been built in this project is a marketing system, a storing system, and processing system. If they would have put up a side by side a industry which could make the grapes, convert the grapes into kishmish, drying industry, lot of grapes could be dried by the machines, and you know the cost of kishmish is also very high. So this problem would have not come. Or they would have put up a processing industry to make grape juices, filled in a bottle, marketed. There could be several ways. I am not suggesting it. But what went wrong in this whole thing was that the development communicator did not see the future need. And that he did not see the long-term need. And that is why the whole project failed. Farmers said, no, let us not grow grapes anymore. We did not get even the price of wheat. We suffered a lot. So this is what is called the issues which have to be taken into consideration in terms of futuristic needs and long-term needs. Now this is a job of the development communicator. So development communicator should be able to identify and define them and explain them so that they understand the problems. So one first step is to explore, to find out the issues, and in terms of futuristic needs, in terms of long-term needs and all that. Then we come to the second step, establishing a common space. I have named it like this. I will explain it to you. On the basis of observation that many development communication projects fail, although they are very good, I would like to mention a project which has been failed and reported in Foster book on technological changes. He said that in one of the African country, the Ford Foundation wanted to do something for the benefit of the ladies, and they found the problem was in winters, in rainy season, the ladies will have to go outside from their house to wash the clothes or to take bath, and they are worried by so many reasons, because it's cold, because the water is not available proper and all that. So what Ford Foundation thought, let us build bathrooms for them so that these ladies can go in the bathroom and wash the clothes without the interference of rain. Even if it is raining, it will not affect. Even if it is cold, it will not affect. In addition to that, they put water tanks on the top of the bathrooms, which will supply them hot water and cold water. This was another thing very interesting. Lady said, yeah, this will be great thing if we can get hot water to wash our clothes, even to take bath and all that. So project went on. After the project was completed and handed over to the local people, ladies groups and the Ford Foundation thought it's a big job we have done. After a year, they said, let us evaluate the project, how much it has been successful and all that. If it is successful, we should be able to do some another thing for them, poor ladies. So a team went there to find out how successful it was. Team was surprised that nobody using bathrooms. So they asked these ladies, why are you not using bathrooms? You are still washing the clothes near the pond. When there is any season, you may have to break and stay back for washing the clothes. If it is winter, you are suffering from cold. Lady said, yes, this is what is happening. Then they said, why, when you are careful, when you know all these things, why you are not going to bathrooms to wash or take bath there itself? Then one of them said, you see, the most important thing which has been forgotten, in bathrooms, they are separate bathrooms, and we get, each of us get locked up in the bathroom. We cannot talk to each other, gossip, sing song. Here near the pond, we are gossiping, we are sharing family news, we are singing songs, and we are enjoying, we are not feeling tired. But in closed bathrooms, we feel very much tired, because there is nobody to talk. Everybody is in different bathrooms. They understood, the team understood what has gone wrong, that the development communicator saw the need from the upper layer, but he did not explore that what is the basic thing is there in washing the clothes in the pond is community sharing of news, because ladies don't get time. They get time only to share their views with other ladies. After they go to different homes, and they are no way to share. Now this is the point which has to be understood, that if you want project to be successful, not only you just identify the issues and problems and build the project on that. No, you must also try to find out that if this project is executed, implemented, then what are going to be the results? Are there some hidden things in this? Are there some other problems? If you would have shared before the project with the ladies might, one of the ladies or some ladies might have indicated this problem. So you could have made a pond, instead of separate bathrooms, a common pond in within the bathroom, which gives hot and cold water. And then they could have easily used it. This is not difficult. That's what the point you have to consider. Now the projects fail because of the faulty project design, as I just explained to you. It fails because the beneficiaries do not accept it and do not feel this is their project. Third, fails because insufficient involvement of the people. These are three important reasons. There could be some more reasons also, but all important reasons for failing a project can be categorized into three. That is the faulty design, beneficiary non-acceptance, and insufficient involvement. Therefore, when these are the things, when you know it because of the reasons, then how to solve this problem? How to design your project without any fault? How to involve people so that they accept your project and they get involved in the project itself? These are the three things. So for that, what are the tools available to the development communicator? First tool is called transect walk. Transect walk. What does it mean? You walk with them. You go with them. Talk to them. Share their ideas. Discuss the issues, the problems, all that. So one tool is a transect walk. Second tool is you work out trend lines. What is trend line? Trend line means this group of people, what type of trends they have and they are interested in getting the problem solved. And then you note down their calendar of activities, maybe 1 week or 2 weeks. What are the activities in which they are involved? They are interested. For example, as I gave you the earlier example of Mr. Foster's book, Technological Changes, the calendar of activities were not noted properly. That each woman from families, all they go to pond to wash clothes. And what is very important, community sharing. I am very happy if you have seen the budget of this year, Modi's budget, in which they have allotted 1,000 crores for building the community radio stations, which is very important. There is no point in making all India radio channels more and more, because each no news bulletin indicates if I live in Greater Kailash, what happened in Greater Kailash yesterday, who expired, or which child got the first prize in Greater Kailash. I don't know. I hear that there was a train accident in Tokyo, or I hear an accident happened in Madras. How do I am concerned? I live in Greater Kailash. I must know what is happening in my Greater Kailash area where I live, or whatever where I. So if there is a community radio which have functional only for 10 or 15 kilometers, in which only the community news will come. Who got promotion? Who has got what new things? Who has gone abroad? Which student got the prize? Who stood first? Now that I will be interested to know. And presently I have no information. Where I live, I don't know what is happening there. So I think it's a very positive step to have community radio stations to feed this type of news items to the people who live in that community, what is happening to that community. So therefore, the other thing which was important, we must find out what the people want there who are living in that area. So this was the second step, important step, which has to be taken.
Sir, if I can interrupt you, I want to ask a question. So you talked about the various tools like Transact, Walk and Trend Lines. So for instance, when we say start a project, a trend may be different, but trends keep changing. So is the development communicator also responsible for updating the project?
You see, it is always better that in updating the project is of course important, but sometime what happened, project has got boundaries. They always fix these are the aims and objectives, and you will have to take activities according to only objectives and aims fixed. Now development communicator what can do, when he finds there is something which has come new, he must try to associate with one of the objectives or activities, and then it will work.
Right.
If it does not associate, then people will say, no, this is important, you are not taking up this. He should consider them and see how it can be merged into the present objectives of the project.
Yes.
And how these activities can be undertaken under that objectives.
Right.
So that type of thing, capabilities, the person should be able to have and do it. Then only he will be successful. Suppose you don't consider that, then they will say, what is this? We are not interested in this project. Your project does not touch this problem. So that person intelligently will have to see how he can merge, how he can add, or what activities can be added so that this thing can be taken care
right.
of.
Thank you, sir.
That is what an important role of development communicator. Development communicator is basically a leader, a problem solver, a person who does the problem analysis and then he tries to work out. That's why some of our great leaders were very successful, because they understood the problem of the people and their need, and then they developed the project on that. That's why they were successful.
Right.
Let us come to the next step, which some of which thing we have discussed earlier also, is the identification of felt needs, because this question came earlier. Problems, risk, opportunities and solutions. How many? There are five things. Identification of felt needs, problems, risk, opportunities and solutions. I think we have discussed about felt needs. Let us discuss about problems. What is a problem? Problems are man-made. People think the God has made the problem. No. You have made the problem. And when a man has made a problem, then you will have a solution. No problem is without solution. If there is no solution, then there is no problem. You take any problem, and try to find out why this problem has come. And then you will find because of the faulty design of some individuals, this problem has come to you. So therefore, problem analysis has to be learned. And you may, the participants may not learn, but at least the development communicator should know problem analysis techniques. There is special, I will talk little later about the problem analysis technique, but problem analysis has to be understood. Then risks, what are the risks? If you implement the project, you must find out. And another interesting thing, you must find out what are the opportunities exist. In the society, in the community, there are already opportunities. Only thing, you will have to identify where is this opportunity. And of course, you will have to identify the solutions. Now, what tools you can use for this? One is, of course, baseline study. What does baseline study means? Baseline study means that you analyze the situation, and before launching the development communication project, you must have the full data available in terms of the objectives of the project from the society. Without baseline data or baseline study, it's very difficult to build up or test our objectives and all that. So therefore, first is baseline study. Second is verify, validate, and quantify the achievements. In objectives, you have written that these are the things to be done. Now, those things which have to be done, you must validate whether it is possible to be done or it cannot be done. Or it, if it is possible, then to what extent I can do it. Quantify it, because you can't do 100%. So you say, well, I am satisfied even if 30%, 40%, 50% will accept it and do it. So verify, validate, and quantify. The other thing is, which is a very interesting tool, called problem tree. What is problem tree? You must have seen in some places people prepare family tree, that these were the two gentlemen, name of the person and name of the wife, then they had three children, then from these three children the family grew. That's called family tree. In the same way, problem tree. Whatever problems you have or the target audience has, you go on listing them. Don't discourage. Go on listing. Once you have prepared the list of all the problems, they may be big, they may be small, they may be even felt need, whatever. Then try to put them in a family tree. There are problems which have come out because of some other problem, because of some other issue. So therefore, you will be able to categorize them into branches, group them, classify them. Once you classify them, then you know this is a one chunk of problems which are more or less are similar. And if I can do one thing, then most of these problems will be solved. That type of tree, either is a problem tree or solution tree. You can always say this is the solutions, this for problem tree. So problem tree and solution tree will help you in better classification and also better identification, and also it will help you to focus your activities, your views about that. Then you can arrange some focused group interviews. Focus group means the find out from the group interviews what are their problems. The next is community resource mapping. What is community resource mapping? Every community has resources. It is wrong to say that this community doesn't have the resources. They developed their own resources on the basis of this. So you map them. What are the resources they have? They may have a mine there, or they may have cattle belt, or they may have a river flowing nearby, or they may have ponds. These are the resources. Now you will ask me, what is the use of these resources? Yes. If you have found that there are ponds in the village, 5 ponds are there, then you think of how this resource can be used. You may turn one of the pond and grow those things like fishes, prawns, that will give them income, that will give them nutritive food. This has been observed that if you turn the resources into giving them help, either in terms of money earning and all that, then it will be very useful to them. So, but you have to do the resource mapping. There may be a lot of youths available, then you say there is labor availability, and what can be done, how it can be used. The next point is, after you have done resource mapping, then find out the related issues, you work it out, which are existing there. The interesting part is, you must also find out what are the communication channels they are using. Do they use newspaper? Do they use radio? Do they use television? Or do they use the group chatting, or what they use? Because once you identify which are the important channels of communication, then you will put your message through those channels so that you can control it. Next thing is, you must also find out cost effectiveness of channel. Which channel will cost you for communicating in terms of rupees? Which channel will cost you in terms of rupees? So cost effectiveness. And then find out which is the channel through which you can persuade them much better. The step 4 is a prioritization and reconciliation. That is, individual perception in this step is very important task. We say window of perceptions. This is technique used for this purpose. The people should be able to perceive in a manner which is convincing to them and also very useful. I was saying 2 days back, when railway budget came out, some of the interviewer went inside the compartment and were asking questions to the travelers. Sir, the cost of ticket has increased, our fares have increased. How do you react to it? He said, yes, fares have increased, all right. They were already very less. But when fares have increased, they must increase the facilities. We don't mind paying extra. Now you see, important thing. We don't mind paying extra if the facilities are provided. So they have paying capacity. They are not saying that they will not pay. And they are ready to pay for the facilities to be provided. It means the key issue is facilities. You increase the facilities, charge more for the facilities. You give better type of food, increase the price of the food. Give them RO water everywhere, clean water to drink on all platforms and throughout the train, they are ready to pay. So what does it indicate? It indicates there are issues which have to be identified. People have certain priorities that has to be taken into consideration, and then you have to reconcile, well, this could be done. I was always thinking, why good water is not given in trains? Where is the problem? You can supply unlimited good powder, good type of water for drinking. But somebody has to make an effort. Now, this requires that all the key issues are listed, then they prioritize which one will be taken first, which match with your objective. So this is what I will do. And then you develop the final program. In this, one technique is also very useful, which is called pair-wise preference ranking. What is pair-wise reference ranking? This technique is, you ask them, do you like this or this? And then you make it pair. So after you have made the pair-wise thinking, then you will be able to rank this type of thing. There is no problem about it. So please take care of this, that all validate your findings and define solutions. That is the last step of this thing, where the decision making process comes from problem analysis and problem solving process itself. If you are done this, I am sure that your project will be successful and there will not be a problem. Thank you very much.
Right. Thank you so much, sir, for taking us through these steps of implementing development communication programs, and we really appreciate it. And also for finishing well in time for today's lecture. And with this, I'd like to thank sir for being here. Thank you so much, sir. And also our wonderful listeners and viewers. Thank you so much for taking out time. And we'd like to see you soon. Thank you.